O heavens, and listen, O you earth, land and distant coastland. Lo and behold our finest towers. Please join prayer rally gathering of warriors. Doctrine high horse of worship, prayers and ride with the host of heavens and warriors and charge to battlefield of prayers. For it is written, Jeremiah 20:11. The Lord is with us like a mighty warrior, so our persecutors will stumble and not prevail. They will fail and be thoroughly disgraced. Their dishonor will never be forgotten. Please join the gathering of warriors and charge to the battlefield of prayers. Together we run against troop and scale over walls. Together, we will thresh the mountains, crush them, and reduce the hills to chaff. Together the word of God will come to live in our hands and thunders through the heavenlies. Together, we shall tread upon snakes and lions. Together we shall turn the back battle at the gate. Together we shall wake the dawn. Please join prayer rally gathering of warrior. Every last 3 days of each month on PRZ 109.2 FM. Time 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. UK. The battlefield of prayers, the gathering of warriors. Where the deep calls unto the deep.
And together this very hour, as I welcome you to the presence of the Most High, we shall trash through the gate of Rephidim in the mighty name of Jesus and summon the Amalekite before the Lord. Thanks so much for tuning in to PRZ 109.2. You have just tuned in to Prayer Rally Night Vigil Conference, and my name is Remy Kende Tawo. I'm broadcasting live from PRZ London Studio. The Lord will honor you. I welcome you to the presence of the Most High. It's going to be glorious in the mighty name of Jesus. Thanks for returning, for those who are returning for this day two of the Battle of Rephidim. Those who are returning, I welcome you to the presence of God. And for those who are tuning in for the very first time, I say you are welcome to the presence of God. I welcome people of great understanding, people who know, who have an understanding of, who can pants and pursue whatever they believe, who have an understanding of the word of God, the power, the life, the manifestation of God's glory in their lives. I welcome you. I welcome all the royal, the nobles, those with nobility in the kingdom of God. I said, thou art welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. It will be awesome. Let me say to someone, it will be awesome as we walk and as we trash through the holy, straight word of the Lord in this holy convocation before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you to day two of the Battle of Rephidim, day two, the Prayer Rally Night Vigil Conference. Together we rise up and we unlock the heavens everywhere, all over the world, wherever you are across the globe. Please rise up with me and unlock the heavens above you in the mighty name of Jesus as we declare this meeting closer. This meeting open in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to declare it open wherever you are and unlock the heavens in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you to this very hour in the presence of God. I welcome you to an altar of prayer, a time, a season of victory, a season when you will summon your enemy before the Lord, a season when you will recall a time for memorial. The theme for this conference, let me say to someone, the very theme for this conference is write it for a memorial in your book. Someone, let me say it, I will write this. This one will be for a memorial before the Lord. Let me say that in the mighty name of Jesus. As you decree it, so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. For by God tonight, let me say, we will run against troop. And by our God, I say to someone, we will leap over wall according to the word of the psalmist in Psalm 18, verse 29, in the mighty name of Jesus. Because I declare before the throne of grace and before you saints that in Christ, Yekima, according to the book of Acts, chapter 17, I think verse 28, I said, for in him, I declare, Yekima, so we live. In him, we move. In him, Yekima, we will have our being in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you to the altar of God. Please declare it open wherever you are. Someone help me declare it open in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare this meeting open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Begin to welcome the presence of God and declare fire, Yekima. Let there be fire upon your wall. Help me declare it, because this is prayer conference for those who are returning, for those who are standing, for those who are ready, for those who are ready to run before with the host of heavens tonight. In the mighty, I'm excited. Yeah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Please declare your wall with fire. Declare war around you, because in the book of Zechariah 2:5, it said, for I will be, Yekima, a wall of fire around it. Help me personalize it as you rise up with me. The Lord God will be a wall of fire around us, around somebody under the sound of my voice, around me right now in this studio, somebody under the sound of my voice. Who will stand up? Who will rise up and say, but the Lord, and decree it before the throne of it, will be a wall of fire around us in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus. And it will be the glory within it. Begin to declare it. The glory of God will be within my tent, will be within my walls, will be within my life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to declare it. Because tonight we turn the battle at the gate. I turn one other sound of my voice. We will declare the presence of God, the glory of God, the manifestation of God in their life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the fire of God begin to burn around and about in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. Please welcome the Spirit of God with me as I welcome the presence of God in this place. Begin to welcome the presence of God, someone, in the mighty name of Jesus. Who will go, who is ready to flow. Blessed are those with their Bible. They're blessed are those with their pen. And just worship the Lord with me. Worship the Lord in this place. Across the globe, let's just give it all unto Him. This very hour, we say, God, you are welcome in this place, in our home, in this situation, in our circumstances. Just worship the Lord, as we declare, as we swing, as the gates of the Rephidim. This is the battle of Rephidim. This shall be for a memorial. I speak to someone who will flow in their spirit, and say, Lord God, you are welcome in this place. You are welcome in our life. You are welcome in this season. You are welcome in this circumstance. You welcome God, Yekimakosoro. Thou art welcome. We just welcome you, Yekima. Thou art welcome, O God, in this season, O God, in our lives. We welcome you, Yekimakosoro, and just flow into your spirit, Yekimakosoro. Yekimakosoro, Yekimakasandra. Welcome the Spirit of the Lord, Yekimakosoro. God, you are awesome. Someone declare that word, that you are awesome in this place, Lord. Help me declare that before the Lord. Begin to declare it. You are awesome, oh God. I declare that the awesomeness of God in this place. I declare that. Flow in your spirit that God, you are awesome. Rise up and wave and swing your hand. Say, you are awesome in this situation, oh God. Whatever situation you are going through, just sing with, just flow in the spirit and say, God, you are awesome in that situation. As I start this prayer conference, begin to worship the Lord. Someone under the sound of my head. Begin to declare, hallelujah is the sound of victory, is the word of victory, is the word for, is a song of the warriors. God, you are mighty. Oh God, you are mighty. Oh God, declare it, Yekima. Flow with it, with that song, Yekima. Get to the presence of God. Someone under the sound of my voice, Yekima. Make sure you worship in the spirit and truth, Yekima. Yekima, 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 hallelujah. Yekima, declare it. You will do wonders in our life. You will do wonders in this season, oh God. Declare it. You will do wonders in our life. You do wonders, oh God. You will do great things tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Yeki, lift your voice. Lift your voice. Yeki makosoto, lift your voice. I say, you are a faithful God. Hallelujah. You will do wonders. Please help me rise. I speak to warriors. I speak to shepherdesses. I speak to chaplains. I speak to children of God, the men and women of Zion, of Valor. Please help me rise and begin to declare that God, you are awesome in this place. God, you are mighty. Begin to declare it. God, you are wonderful. Begin to declare it as we go into it. Begin to say it. I will stand with me at the gate of Rapidim tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, the battle of Rapidim. He said, write it for a memorial in your book. Please rise up and begin to declare the awesomeness of God. Make a declaration as well. Beat your chest and go up and down. I remember the word of the psalmist in Psalm 18, verse 42. Psalm 18, 42. He says, then I would beat them. Help me rise up. And then did I beat them as fine as dust before the wind. And I did cast them out as dead in the street. That will be your story. That will be what you will say. Help me rise up. I say, according to the word of the psalmist in Psalm 18, verse 42, I, Yekima, begin to declare, I will beat as fine dust, Yekima, before the wind, every principality, every power, a man or beast that want to stand in my way. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to declare it. You will cast them out in the dead, like in the dead in the street. That is the word of the psalmist. I will cast them out. I will beat them like fine dust. If you believe it, say so. If you know it, say so. If you know it, begin to declare it. As you stand before the Lord, help me declare the word of God in Jesus' mighty name. If you have ever been to the tent of the psalmist, you remember Psalm 35. Help me quote 35 verse 5. May I say, may they be like shaft before the wind as you stand up in the mighty name of anything that want to stand in your way, every principalities and power, anything that does not glorify God around and about. I said they will be like shaft before the wind. Help me declare it with the angels of God. The angels of the Lord, he said, we're driving them away. We drive them away. Begin to declare, begin to decree. Every spirit of slumberness, every laziness, begin. Every spirit, every appearances, begin to say to you, I charge you out in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not be tired every someone. You will not be weary. Begin to say it. I will not be overwhelmed in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not be stressed as someone under the sound of my voice. We will rise up. We will say, I will beat every spirit that is not of God like shaft before the wind. As I stand before the Lord, every word begin to declare that you will say, we turn into sword in your hand, we turn into power, we turn into fire. Begin to declare it. As I stand before the Lord, that which I will say, that which will come out, will be fire in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, write this it for a memorial in your books. That is the theme of this conference. So whatever you do tonight, let it be written. Somebody help me say it. That which I will say, that which I will order, that which I will decree, that which I will begin, the one that you will command, they let it be for a memorial before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. Because memorials, they become relics when they do not stir up a murder conscience, according to the word of an unknown artist, someone under the sound of my voice. Our hearts, I speak to someone, think of life. Our soul, it's full of, it thinks of it, immortality. We're immortal in Christ. Somebody who will rise up and say, we've received every tear of that flows through our eyes. They are tears of joy. They flow through our soul as we stand before the Lord. They are not mark of weakness, I said to someone, but they are mark of power. Whosoever we worship the Lord, whatever is coming out, we release it as sacrifice, as an offering before the Lord, as we stand before the Lord. We will be overwhelmed with joy, Yekima, of speakable love, Yekima. We flow through our soul tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, as we stand with the host of heavens at the gate of refuge, the gate of victory, the gate of history, the narrative history of ancient Israel. You are standing at that gate, and I welcome you back in the mighty name of Jesus. This shall be for a memorial, a remarkable story, and we are going to go through it. I will do an outline. I will do a recap. After the recap, we're going further into it. We will pray. We will talk as we go tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord God will honor you. There's a saying that it is better to die in fighting for freedom than to be a prisoner all day of one's life. But I say to someone, Yeki Makosotoro, that I, Remi Kende Taiwo, I say to warriors, I say to people who are standing at the gate of Rafidim, I said, tonight, okay, it is better to stand tall in victory. I said, it is still better to stand before the Lord than to stand before men in the mighty name of Jesus. It is better as we wake the dawn together tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. This is a battle of victory. It's a battle of freedom. It's a battle of provision. Three things happen all together at Rafidim. Episode at Rafidim. Three things happen, and they shall be for a memorial in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, may you stand and stand well. May you stand in victory in the mighty name name of Jesus, as you roll with me, as you run, Jekima, in the mighty name of Jesus, begin to say, God, register me. Somebody register yourself. Register your household. Everyone under the sound of my voice. Register it, because a psalmist, the word of the psalmist in Psalm 87, verse 87, verse 6, it says, the Lord will write it in the register of the people that this one, Jekima Koso, was born in Zion. Jekima Kasata Rashid. I said, I speak to someone. I said, the word of the psalmist in Psalm 87, verse 6, it says, the Lord God, help me decree it. We write it in the register tonight, Yekima, of the people, Yekima, that this one was born in Zion. Please help me decree it. Please help me declare it. I should stand before the Lord tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, that it shall be said, Yekima, it shall be written, Yekima, that this one, Yekima, was born in Zion. He said, let it be registered among the people. Please register yourself and declare yourself, I'm a daughter of Zion, Yekima, I'm a shepherdess, whatever you are declared before the Lord, let it be registered. He said, the Lord will write it. So I register my name, I register my household, I register my presence. This hour, oh God, it shall be for a memorial. Let it be written in your book, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. You are welcome to the gate of Zion, Rephidim. You are welcome, Yekima, because he said, the Bible said, praise await you, O God in Zion. Unto you, God, we have returned to pay our vows, Yekima Koso. I say and I decree to every warrior under the sound of my voice, that praise of God await him in Rephidim, Yekima. Praise await him. The very first battle, face to face, the first combat, Yekima Koso, man to man, Yekima Koso, the first victory, Yekima, the remarkable one. Three things, someone under the sound of my voice, at the gate of life, who is standing with me at the gate of destiny, at the gate of Rephidim. This shall be for a memorial in the mighty name of Jesus. May you see God in this day in Jesus' mighty name. Please help me rise. Whatever you are saying right now, let them begin to turn into sword. We need the sword of the Spirit. We need the word of God. I want you to wave it in the air. The word that is coming through, let it become a sword in your hand. As you stand at this gate, I say it shall be for a memorial, because the Bible says, Isaiah 26 verse 1, in that day, help me decree it. Isaiah 26, Yekimakum, verse 1, it says, in that day, Yekim, there will be a song. This song will be sung in the land of Judah. This song, help me say it, a great song, Yekim, will rise up in the land of Remiken Etaiwo, in the land of somebody speaking, somebody praying. I said, a song will be sung in the land of Judah, that they have a strong city, that we have a strong war, that God makes salvation in our war, Yekimakum. It shall be said, help me begin to declare it, because you've covered your war with the fire of the Holy Spirit. You've asked for the fire of God to surround your wall. Let me decree it and begin to personalize it. I should stand up at the gate, at the battle of Rephidim, the victory of Rephidim, the remarkable one that shall be written. Please declare it, that in this day, in this hour, in this season, it shall be said, there will be a great song that will be sung in the land, in Jesus' mighty name. As you say it, so shall it be. Let it turn into sword in your hand, in Jesus' mighty name. Another word that is coming through as we march through, as we walk through. We've been going through the gate of Rephidim, but please help me pull out a sword. It's Isaiah 41, verse 31. I'm speaking to warriors who will make sure they secure their gate, they secure their life, they secure their environment, they secure it, because it says, oh, Yekima Kasata, you cover my head in the days of battle. In Psalm 140, verse 7, somebody tries with me and decree the word of God. Isaiah 14, verse 31 is coming through. It says, well, O gates, help me cry out. He said, cry out, O city, melt away, all you Philistine, every begin to say, for a cloud of smoke comes from the north, Yekima, and there are no strangler in its rank. I speak, Yekima, I say, well, Yekima, I speak to gates, Yekima, I say, cry out, O city, Yekima, melt away, let your enemy, let them melt away. As you stand before the Lord, let situation begin to melt away. I'm speaking to someone, that circumstances, let it begin to melt away before the Lord. All you Philistine, all you who ye came across, or the circumcised, begin to let them melt away. Ye came across every principalities and power. I release the fire of God upon it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, and begin to declare it in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, begin to declare, oh warrior, I speak to someone. I'm speaking to warrior. Who will declare a word that will go out? Is it like a bird hovering over it? So the Lord of hosts will protect Jerusalem. Help me declare that. Isaiah 31, verse 5. Isaiah 31, verse 5. I speak to warrior. Who will march up and down? Who will go up and down their tent, their territory, and begin to speak in the spirit. I said, like a bird, Yekima. The Bible said in Isaiah 31, 5, like a bird hovering overhead, so the Lord of hosts, help me call him, Yekima. Help me call him. The Lord of hosts will protect Jerusalem. He will shield us if we deliver it in the mighty name of Jesus. May you be delivered in this season in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, begin to declare that in Jesus' name. The Lord will shield you. The Lord will protect you. He will protect your home in Jesus' mighty name. I said, the Bible says, their rock will pass away for fear and their princes will panic at the sight of the battle standard. Help me begin to declare that. I said, every principality and powers, he said, they will panic at the battle standard. So I release panic into the camp of the enemy right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I release panic, Yekima, around and about anything that does not glorify God. Every spirit that is contrary to the plan, to the spirit of God around and about, I release panic in their camp as you do so, according to the word of God in Isaiah 31:9. May that become fire. May that become sword in your hand in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. For tonight I speak to someone, no longer the word of God will violence be heard in your land, yeah? No ruins, no destruction within your borders. Help me say amen to that in the mighty name of Jesus. It is written, I declare in Isaiah 60 verse 18, and I decree and I declare that it shall be said, help me personalize it, that there will be no violence will be heard in my territory, no violence, no ruins, yeah? No destruction within my borders in the mighty name. Your finances will not be destroyed, help me pray to you. Your home will not be destroyed. That marriage will not go. That business will not be destroyed. That ministry will not be destroyed. It will not crumble. Let me say it. It no longer will violence be had in your territory as you stand with me, as you stand with the host of heaven, as we stand in agreement at the gate at the battle of Rephidim. I welcome you to the presence of God. This shall be for a memorial. He said, write it for a memorial in your book. I quickly will do a recap of day one for those who missed it and for those who are tuning in for the first time. I say, day one, Yekima, the battle of Rephidim. Day one, Yekima, we look at the journey of the Israelites for the seventh station. That was the seventh stop. They left from Ramses. They went from Ramses. The Israelites were thrown out of Egypt from Ramses. And the Bible said they received their freedom. And that was in Exodus. When you look at the Bible in Exodus chapter 12. They left from Ramses. And that was the very first one. It was the journey of freedom. We pray for freedom. Maybe you missed it, but this is your time. If I were you, I would step into it. I would say, as for me, Yekema Kosodo, I will walk out, Yekema. They left from Ramses. I'm speaking to someone. They're a journey of freedom. I say, I release, Yekema, everything that is mine, everything that has my name. Hear ye the word of God. Thou art released in the mighty name of Jesus, where the Spirit of the Lord is. And now, the Bible says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So I declare, Yekima, the Spirit of God is here. The Spirit of God is upon me. The Spirit of God begin to declare that I declare freedom. They will be in the name of Jesus. His blood set me free. His word is setting someone free. His blood is setting someone free. Under the sound of my voice, you will be free, Yekima, from every bondage, every conditional offer, Yekima, every condition that you cannot meet, that is tight, anything that is tying you to a corner, anything that wants to tie your hands, that your hands are tight. If your hands are tight, receive freedom. I speak to someone that every situation that will tie up my hands, I come against it in the mighty. My hands will not be tied. I will not be cornered. My children will not be cornered in the mighty name of Jesus. As we walk through the tent of the battle of Rephidim, we got Rephidim yesterday, and tonight in this hour we are going there again. And let me see the journey. They stay true. The Bible said they went from Ramses and they came to Sukkot. We look at that also. After the Hebrew left, that was the first campsite. They got to Sukkot. The Sukkot is a place that was named by Jacob. Jacob named Sukkot in Genesis, in the book of Genesis. But they got there by the cloud. The Bible says cloud by day. Let me say cloud by day. A pillar of fire which must come down on someone tonight. By night, Yekima, help me decree. There was direction. They had divine direction. And somebody help me pray that by the time they got there, God was guiding their step. This God helped me decree. He will order my step. He will guide my step. He will guide the step of my children. Someone who is there, somebody who is standing in a Rephidim tonight, we ask for divine direction, that the Lord will direct our path in the mighty name of Jesus. As you walk with us, the pillar of fire, walk with the host of heavens. Let the fire of God begin to burn. Begin to burn anything that wants to stand in your way. Eddie Yekima, the pillar of fire, let the fire from the throne of grace, let it come down upon everyone under the sound of my voice. Receive fire, receive power in the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. The third station, let me say, the third one was Pae Hahiroth. The Bible says they passed through the Red Sea onto the other side and they camp in front of it. Help me say, in Exodus chapter 14, in Exodus, they set out from Pae Hahiroth and they passed through the sea into the wilderness. They went, the Bible said, they went a 3 days journey into the wilderness of Etam. Help me say Etam, and they camp at Marah. They went into the wilderness of Etam and we passed through that, and we pray that whatever we pass through, I speak to someone, whether you pass through water, whether you pass through fire, they will not overwhelm you, they will not burn you. As you walk through, somebody who is going to refuge him will not drown. Help me say it. I will not drown. You will not drop in deep waters. In great waters, you will not drown. In angry water, you will not go. In raging water, they will not take you. They will not take your home. They will not scatter your life. Neither will it scatter mine. In the mighty name of Jesus, whosoever is marching to refuge him tonight, the battle of freedom, the battle of freedom, the remarkable one, the legendary one, this I speak to someone, shall be for me memorial. Write it in your book in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. It will come to life. It will come out life to you in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible said they left. Man, we look at that and that first station and what they went through. They got to a place where the water was in the wilderness, where the water was bitter, and the Lord turned around and restored every bitterness, and I turned it around to sweetness. He put sweetness back into the water. It was okay. The Lord did a miracle for them. He turned it around. Lastly, we turn it around tonight. Help me pray. Maybe you missed it. Help me raise your voice that every bitterness, Yekema, every root of bitterness, everything that is making someone to feel bitter, everything that is making someone sorrowful, tonight, Yekima, this hour, you must walk out of my home, of my life, among my children, begin to, in my spirit, begin to say, every root of bitterness, you must yank it, you must get rid of it. That was what the Apostle Paul told the Ephesians, that they must get rid of all bitterness. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 31, somebody who is running to refuge him, we get rid of bitterness and we go quickly. A place of victory, you cannot afford to have bitterness. Please help me pull it out and say anger, rage, anger, whatever it is, in any form, every form of malice, hear ye the word of God, in any shape, every pretense, every color, hear ye the word of God. I take you out in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, the Bible says, be diligent, let there be no root of bitterness. So speak to every bitterness as you pass through, as you're making your way to refute him. Somebody make your way to refute him, but make sure there is no bitterness, because there is no bitterness. For the second time, I call out to everyone under the sound of my voice to get rid of bitterness on their way to freedom, on their way to victory, on their way to provision, on their way, Yekemakosoro, before the Lord, a memorial before the Lord. This shall be for memorial. It's taken from the book of the foundational scripture. It's from the book of Exodus chapter 17, verse 14. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord God, we honor you. The Bible says they got to Elim. We look at that, the fifth station, the fifth stop. They got to Elim and they come there by 12 wells, by 12 springs. They so well, and we use that to pray. If you missed it, please let me rise up. This is your moment. Begin to walk very fast. The well in the desert, in the wilderness of life, there could be well of joy. We pass through well of joy. We look at well of honor, the well of grace, the well of gold, the well of favor, the well of peace, the well of life. Jesus said on the last day, the greatest of the feast, he stood and he called out in a loud voice. That's what the Bible says. If anyone is thirsty, let them come to me and drink. Is the well of life. We look at the well of life. Maybe you miss it. Begin to pray that those well, everything, whatever is popping through your spirit, make sure you are passing through the well. Make sure you are speaking to the well. Then let that be well of joy, Yekima. You must draw out water from with joy, Yekima. With joy, you will draw out water. Water of salvation. There is well of salvation. Somebody understand. There is well of peace. They must not elude you. Begin to call them to appear in every way in your journey in life, Yekima. Speak to wilderness, Yekima. I will speak to wilderness of life. I will speak to something that looks like a desert. I will speak to a hard situation. Somebody help me begin to call out. Let that be well. Let well begin to come forth. Yekima. Call it to show up. Every begin to whatever well you need. If it's well of wealth, if it's well of gold, if it's well of oil, oil of grace. Yekima. Begin to call it. But something must come out from that dry land. Something must come out. Whatever is dry. Yekima. The well that will refresh you. The water of life. The water, Yekima. The living water. The one that you will drink and live. Let it come, begin to soul. You will not die, Yekema, but live to declare the water of healing. Let it begin to well. The well of healing, let it begin to come out. May you draw out of that with joy in the mighty name of Jesus. The well of salvation, may somebody get it in the mighty name of Jesus. So they went, they passed through Etam. Let me say they passed through Etam. As you passed through the well, they saw 12 well, and we identified 12 well, and we prayed with it. If you missed it, this is your time. May you receive yours. May you come. May your well begin to appear, Yekeme, in every area of your life, in your journey, Yekeme. You will not lack water. You will not lack it. You will be refreshed, Yekeme, in the mighty name. You will not be frustrated. Help me pray. I will not be frustrated. Every arrow of frustration, begin to pull it out. I'm speaking to warriors. I'm speaking to mothers in Israel. I'm speaking to villain men and women. I'm speaking to noble ones, Yekeme, who always sit at the gate, who always show up in the place of prayer. I say, Yekeme, you will not be dry, Yekeme. The Lord will refresh you in the mighty name of Jesus. So they were refreshed. Episode they were refreshed on the way to Rephidim. We looked at that. And the sixth one, episode the sixth one, the wilderness of sin. The Bible said he sent manna, that he said provision, ease came upon their life. The quail, the Bible said, they to feed the Israelites, divine provision. Please help me pray. As you are making my way in this season, Rephidim, you will not lack. Help me pray. I will not lack manna from heaven. Let them begin to come out, because the Bible says, see, Yekim, I speak to someone according to the word, and you will see the glory of God in the morning. Help me declare that according to the word of God in the book of Exodus. Begin to declare in the book of Exodus chapter 7. It said, see, Yekima, I speak to someone. You will see the glory of God. May you see the glory of God in this season. May manna from heaven, the Bible for provision, begin to come. May things begin to drop within your reach, O God. May lights begin to fall for you, Yekima, in pleasant places, within reach, in easy places, FPC to someone, in close places that you can reach out. You can reach, Yekima, in the mighty name of Jesus. Divine provision, your provision will not be too far. It will not have condition. Your divine provision will not be attached. It will fall on your lap in the mighty name of Jesus. It will fall within reach. It will rain. The God that reigns, this manner, and the grace from heaven, may it rain for dews and rain upon your land in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone. I say, may the work of your children, may the field of your children, may the smell of your children smell like the field, like the cloth, like the work that the Lord has blessed, according to the word of Isaac, to Jacob. He said, but the smell of my child in Genesis 27:27, smell like this field that the Lord has blessed. Please let me say that. May your well be like the feel that the Lord has blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. May you be like fruitful bowl, the blessing that was placed upon Joseph. You will go over walls, you will grow over walls in the mighty name of Jesus. May you be a blessing, may you be blessed, and may you be a blessing in the mighty name of Jesus as you walk through Rephidim, as you make your way to Rephidim in the mighty name of Jesus. So Rephidim is the seventh stop. Help me say it's the seventh stop. Help me underline that is the seventh stop. They fought with the Amalek. So tonight, let me stand very well as we speak to every Amalite, because in Rephidim, the Bible says, as we looked at it, that is also called Massa, a place of test. Mariba, a place where they contended, where they quarrel, a place where they raised complaint against the Lord. Is God still among us? They were still asking questions after eating manna, after having quail to eat. They said, is God still among us? Because they could not get water to drink. And God asked Moses to make his way to Horeb, to make his way to the burning bush. So we look at that. We say there's a large wilderness area of about 1,000 square meter. If you're good in geography, about 1,000 meter on the map when you look at it. And there are two places of Meribah which we identify. The one at Rephidim, the Meribah that was named at Rephidim, and another Meribah that Moses sinned against the Lord. So this Meribah is different in the wilderness of Kadesh Barnea, that Moses sinned in striking the rock, and that too was also Meribah. So I welcome you to Rephidim. For those who are joining in for the first time, you are welcome back to again to Rephidim. But it says, write this in your book. So they were attacked. This is where they fought the Amalekites, the very first battle. They were weak at the time of their weakness. The Amalekites came to fight them. Came to fight them. No weapon of war. They came out. They were being fed. They were at they were being fed by the Lord at the time when the Amalekites came to cross them, to challenge them, because I am speaking to someone. And the Bible says when they got to that terrain, epistle terrain, whosoever is climbing, whosoever is walking through Rephidim, we understand that the Rephidim terrain is very rocky. Epistle is very rocky, because the Bible says in Exodus, let me look at Exodus chapter 17 as we look at the story and we pray tonight, that then all the congregation, all the sons of Israel, they journey in stages, by stages, from the wilderness of sin according to the command of the Lord. They had to do it. They camped at Rephidim. So before Rephidim, they were doing it in stages. They had to go step by step. They had to go group by group. I'm speaking to someone. They were going the little, the weak one, the strong one, they were going there. It was rocky. At the rocky stage, the Amalekite attacked them. There was no water for the people to drink. That was what the Bible says in Exodus. Let me say Exodus chapter 17, verse 1. But the foundational scripture is Exodus 17, verse 14, and we we realized that the Israelites spent 3 days there, Yekima, from the Red Sea while they were crossing. The Rephidim is an important stop in history, where they complain, as we said, they complain all the way of no water, and the Amalekites attack them. Moses, at Rephidim, that was where Moses climbed the hill, which I want us, he climbed the hill and held his hand up in the air, and we noticed that three people climbed that hill. It was Moses, it was Aaron, it was Hur. The Hur is the father of Caleb. He climbed, and it was the first time they appeared in history. He showed up, the three men that went up to the hill to pray before the Lord, so that the Israelite could win. And heaven recorded it. They were sitting in the book of history along with these great people, especially Hur, the father of Caleb, sitting with them, the elders of elders, I'm speaking the leaders of leaders. He was among them one night, one day, at the battle of Rephidim. Someone also will journey, make this journey before the Lord today, in the mighty name of Jesus. As we go in, this shall be for a memorial. We want to look at it. It will not be the first time the Lord will say this at the memorial. He told them, there were on three occasions, God used the word, this shall be for a memorial. I'm speaking to someone, because in verse 17, let's go to Exodus 17, verse 13, he says, and so I speak to them. Joshua defeated the Amalekites. We know the Amalekites are the descendant of Esau. They are the descendant of Esau, and his people, with the edge of sword, they were defeated. Even though they appeared fully armed, they were defeated. I speak to warrior. He said, we are not like the children of Ephraim. That's what the Bible said. Fully armed, but turn back in the days of battle, according to Psalm 78. I said, we are not like them, the men of Ephraim, the Ephraites, who are fully armed in battle and turn back. So they were defeated. Let me say, they were defeated. Then, verse 14, let me look at Exodus chapter 17, verse 14. Then the Lord said to Moses, write this for a memorial in your book. Recount it in the hearing of Joshua. So Joshua could not read. Recount it very well. Say it over and over. But you write it. This is the record. This is the proof that he's been writing it. And he wrote the five books, the first five books. Okay? They call them the five books of Moses. He said, write them for a memorial in the book. So he's been writing something all along. He said, do not forget this. Include this, because I will utterly, and let me look at it, Yekima, I will utterly blot out the remembrance of Amalekite from under the sun, Yekima. And the Bible says in verse 15, Moses built an altar and called it, the Lord is my banner. Me say, the Lord is my banner. You will find it in Exodus chapter 17, verse 15. The Jehovah Nissi. For he said, because the Lord has sworn, which he will swear to someone tonight, the Lord has sworn that he will have war with Amalekite from generation to generation. The Lord has sworn, because your first battle, the first person, the first confrontation, the first spoken evil word, the first negative word, you must cancel, you must redeem, you must turn around, you must flip around, you must charge before the Lord. Those ones you must bring before the Lord. They are your Amalekites. Every negative word, every first struggle, every first challenge, every first that you can recollect, and the first disappointment, I'm speaking to someone, whatever it is, drag them, pull them, push them anyhow, also before the Lord tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. That is Rephidim. He said, write them, Yekema, let it be in your book, Yekema, because the Lord vowed one night that he will not forget it. He will remember this. This that that they did. I will call them into remembrance because they did this unprovoked. Why would they come? They were moving in stages. They were weak. They were moving. It was a rocky terrain, and they were moving in stages. They attacked them, pam, and the Bible recorded it. When you look at Deuteronomy 25:17-19, remember what Amalekite did to you along the way. That's what the Bible said. When you came out from Egypt, how he met you along the way and attacked among you all the stranglers at your rear end, at the back, when they were faint and weary, those who are weak, they attacked them from the back and weary, and they did not fear God. That was, he said, they did not fear God. He said, remember, you will find this in Deuteronomy chapter 25, verse 17 to 19. I'm speaking to someone. I said, you will find this in Deuteronomy 25, verse 17 to 19. Therefore, the Bible says, it shall come about when the Lord your God has given you rest. I am speaking to someone. Now that you have got rest on every side, the Lord said, and the Lord your God gives you as an inheritance to possess. He shall blot out every memory of Amalekite. Whatever stand like Amalekite under the heavens, you must not forget. You must drag before the Lord that which you can remember. Your first disappointment. I said, the frustration, the first challenge, the first negative accusation, someone under the sound of the negative spoken word that keep ringing in your ears, that when you remember, you can tell this is the source of the problem, the source of challenges, the source of whatever it is. Drag them, pull them. Take them before the Lord. It shall be for memorial. Present them before the Lord. For the Bible says, and the Lord remember this very word. So it's 1 Samuel chapter 15, Ephesians 15, verse 7. And this is what the Lord Almighty says. I will punish the Amalekites for what they did to Israel when they waylaid them, they crossed them, yeah, as they came out from Egypt. The Lord said, I will punish them. So whosoever is coming out of bondage, whosoever is coming out of mess, whatever I want to stand in your way after you have been set free, Yekimakoso, whatever I want is Amalekite, is the Amalekite, you will speak to it. He said, now the Bible says in verse 3, now go and attack the Amalekite and totally destroy them, all that belongs to them, and do not spare them, put them to death. That was the instruction God gave to Saul, and he failed. But the Lord remember now that they had rest, because he had already promised them in Deuteronomy 25 verse 17 to 19 that once they get rest, he will revisit them. Help me say, the Lord revisit every negative word. They must turn around in the mighty name. Revisit every mess, every disgrace, somebody under the sound of my voice, that they will not happen again. Drag them, pull them before the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible says, and this write it for a memorial in your book. I speak to someone, for memorial in your book, because the first time God told them about writing things for a memorial was in Exodus. I say Exodos chapter 12 verse 14. He said the time when God was the day of Passover, he said, this I speak to someone, shall be a day you are to celebrate for generation to generation to come. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord, a lasting ordinances. That was what God said. A freedom must be celebrated. God told them, he said, this shall be for a memorial. This you must not forget. This you must do from generation to generation. This you must, salvation must be celebrated. It shall be for a memorial. You must celebrate it in the mighty name of Jesus. God told them that they must celebrate it. They must write it in their hand as a remember. They must do this all the time in that he has brought them out of Egypt. They must write it. Even Exodus 13 verse 9, he said, it shall be a sign for you on your hand and a reminder on your forehead, that the law of the Lord is to be on your lips. You must know, I'm speaking to someone, that for with a mighty hand, Yekima, the Lord has brought you out of every appearances of Egypt. He said, you must not forget. I'm speaking to someone, because the Bible said, we overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. You must not forget. Whatever it is, it shall be for a memorial. That was what God told them in the mighty name of Jesus. So help me rise. The psalmist says in Psalm 136 verse 12, that the mighty hand, the outstretched hand, his loving devotion endures forever. This Lord, with his mighty hand, with his outstretched hand, they endure forever. He will pull me out of every mess. I will summon every negative case, begin to charge them before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall be for a memorial. For this, Isaiah 49, 16, the prophet said the word of God, that I have engraved you. I speak to someone. You have been engraved in the palm of his hand. Your words are ever before him. They shall be for a memorial. I'm speaking to someone. I said, they shall be for a memorial. Begin to speak to the Lord that you have already written me in the palms of your hand. Help me speak before the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, may the Lord remember you in Jesus' mighty name. When they crossed the Red Sea, when they crossed Jordan, God also told them that the waters of Jordan were cut off before you, before the ark of the Lord, when they crossed Jordan. He said, these stones that he asked them to gather together in Joshua, episode Joshua chapter 4, verse 7, they shall be for a memorial. The battle of Gilgal. I said, they shall be for a memorial. He asked them to gather the stone so that they will remember. Well, I don't know what the Lord has done for you, but whatever it is, if I were you, I will lift them before the throne of grace. I said, this shall be for a memorial. Let them be upon the throne of remembrance. I will make my way to the throne of remembrance. I will make sure I enter the throne of remembrance tonight. And I will call unto the Lord, Yekemakoso, that which you have done, O God. The victory shall be for a memorial. In this season, in the mighty name of Jesus, even his name, the Bible says, they are for memorial. Because Isaiah said it in Isaiah, the word of God in Isaiah 56, verse 5. Help me say Isaiah 56, verse 5. I said, I will give them, the Lord promised, in my house, Yekema, within my walls, help me say amen, a memorial, a name better than that of sons and daughter. I will give them an everlasting name that they will not be cut off. Help me rise up that in this season the Lord will give us a name as a memorial. He said, I will give them, Yekemen, a memorial upon my wall. The Lord will not forget me. Begin to pray in this in mighty name of Jesus. I'm speaking to warriors who will stand. He said, write them down in your book, Yekema, as a memorial before the Lord. Let your name be written in his book as a memorial before the Lord. Your needs, let them be written in his book as a memorial before the Lord. Your thanksgiving, somebody has not spoken, let them be written. I say, let my thanksgiving, my worship, let them be written before you as a memorial. Begin to speak. Let heaven hear you. You're standing this hour, this minute, as you wake the dawn, at this hour is a sacrifice before the Lord. Let them be as a memorial. Your deeds in the house of the Lord. I'm speaking to someone. Your offering, your seed, your tithe, let them be as a memorial before them. Say, write them down in your book, Yekimakosoro. Write it as a memorial in your book. I speak to someone, maybe write them down, whatever the Lord is doing, those testimonies, write them down in your book just a memorial. Whatever the challenge is, write them down in your book, because God must revisit every power, every principality, every Amalekite in this season, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Please help me rise up and begin to pray. Begin to pray. Pray to every situation. I'm speaking to circumstances. I'm speaking to everything. Every negative thing. I like prayer of anticipation, because it gives strength to those who turn the battle at the gates. So I stand before the Lord. At refugee, I declare victory. Help me declare victory. They had victory. The Amalekites were defeated. So I defeat. I begin to speak. I call out every spirit of Amalekite around about me. I said that you will be defeated. You are defeated at Rephidim, Yekema. So they will be defeated in the mighty name of Jesus. As I pass through it in this season, oh God, everything that is fighting you from the back, Yekema, from areas of weakness, at when you are weak, Yekema, at your weak point, whatever is waiting for you in the valley of life, begin to speak to it in the mighty name of Jesus. I said, yeah, everything that has waited, that is waiting, that is angry, that is planning, Yekema, that is looming, that is locking around at the valley of life, at the rocky terrain, when you are tired and fainting, everything that is waiting to strike, I speak the word of God. I speak out fire. I say, let the word of God go ahead. God, you must remember this one. So God, everything that is locking around, I bring them, whatever has attacked, at the time of rest, I say, bring them before the Lord. The Bible says, when men slept, enemy came. When men slept, begin to pray. At the time of your when you were weary, when you are tired, when you are fainting, whatever attacked you at that time, bring them before the Lord. Whatever is attacking your prayer altar, whatever is attacking you that you cannot fast, whatever is attacking you that is making you weak, whatever is attacking you that is making somebody to cry, whatever is attacking you that is making you to stress, whatever is attacking that is making you to fear, then hear ye the word of God. Bring them before the Lord tonight. The Lord is here tonight. I bring you all out, whatever you are struggling with, whatever you are struggling with, begin to pull out, begin to drag. You will get to the presence of God. Set them on fire. These ones, oh God, remember, all the struggles, all the humiliation, all the reproach, begin to bring them begin to drag them before the Lord. This is Rephidim. He said, write them in the memory, in your book. The Lord will visit them. Every reproach, every negative word they have spoken into your life, every shame, every joke, every walk of shame, every walk of, drag them before the Lord. This is Rephidim. And say, Lord God, this once shall be for memorial, because it was the attack that God wanted to remember. The victory he had given them. But whosoever attacked them, at the time of their weakness, he wants to bring them to account, to record. Begin to call out in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is here. I speak to someone. I say, the Lord is here for someone. The Lord is here in this place. The Lord is here. The Lord is here in this place for someone. Someone who will pray. Someone who will shout. Someone who will scream and say, Lord God, you will begin to pray in your spirit. You begin to pray with all your heart. Begin to pray and pray. Begin to pray. One man, one day, decided to call unto the Lord and say, God, begin to pray. Somebody, I speak to you. Begin to pray. Someone under the sound of my voice, begin to call out to the Lord. One man, one day, rose up and started praying and singing before the Lord. Pray before the Lord. Someone under the sound of my voice. Someone who is running, somebody who is running and dragging everything out. That Lord God, tonight, the battle of Rephidim, this shall be for a memorial. I speak to someone. They too, begin to stand, begin to worship the Lord, begin to call out, begin to pray in your spirit. Go into another level. In the mighty name of Jesus, go into another level. Change your spirit. Let your spirit pray. Let your spirit pray before the Lord that God. Oh, this is the vision. As you make your way before the Lord, the battle of Rephidim, they too, as you begin to pray before the Lord, may your spirit pray before the Lord. May you pray, may you stand before the Lord. May that which you're saying be written in the book of life. May the Lord remember you. May the Lord remember your tears. May it be written in his book. He will call out your tears. Call out the word. I said, bring them into remembrance before the Lord. And say, Lord God, May you begin to pray. May your spirit begin to pray. May you remember, even your tears, bring them before the Lord. Let them be in his books, your works before the Lord. Your journey, your sweat, your mind, begin to bring them, oh God. Let your spirit pray, begin to bring them before the Lord. And say, this shall be for memorial, your seed, everything that you have gone through, bring them before the Lord. Pull them before the Lord. Drag them before the Lord. And say, God, this also shall be for a memorial in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone under the sound of my voice, anyone that is sick right now, I say receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone, I say he sent his word and healed them. So I send the word of life, the word of power, the word of healing into every bone in the mighty name of Jesus. As you make your way before the Lord, I speak to every tear that is flowing right through. May the Lord remember you in the mighty name of Jesus. May you be remembered in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone who has worked so hard, they have labored so hard. I speak to your labor, I speak to your work, I speak to your sweat. I present them before the Lord. I speak to my, I say, may they be for a memorial in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to every seed, I pray to every act, I speak to every word, every reproach, blot them out. I say, Lord God, you will revisit this one, you will shut the mouth of my enemy, you will keep their mouth shut, you will take him and begin to say it in the way. They will be like fine dust, Yekima. They will be like fine dust in the air in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever has struggled with you, whatever you have wrestled with, I say, hear you the word of God. Begin to bring them into remembrance. Even dreams, Yekima, every dream, Yekima, every scary dream, every challenges, drag them before the Lord, that God, you will revisit this. He said, write them down so that it will not be forgotten, that these ones I will revisit. I will come back from generation to generation. I will come back for them. God, whatever has made your life hard, to make you to struggle, make you attack, let them be brought to books. Let them be brought before the Lord. I drag them, every court cases, every fine, every situation, every financial mess. If I were you, I'll begin to pull out, I'll begin to drag out, begin to look around. What can I bring before the Lord? Everything and anything that's troubling your mind, that is on your mind, that you want God to remember, please help me drag them out as you stand before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. In this season, may the Lord see you. That which you present, may the Lord see it in the mighty name of Jesus. The battle of Rephidim, it shall be said in Israel. It shall be written, it shall be registered. I said, this one was also from Zion. I said, this one also have been to the presence of God. You have been to a place of prayer. You have joined the warriors, the prayer rally gathering of warriors, Yekimaus, the gathering of champions, the gathering of shepherdesses, I said the gathering of knights. You have been there, Yekim. You have prayed, Yekim. You have been standing. May you stand and stand well and stand with the host of heavens in this season in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we just thank you and we call this to a close. I speak to everyone under the sound of my victory is yours in Jesus' mighty name. As we march before the Lord, as we stand before the Lord, as I march, oh God, in triumph before the host of heaven with the host, Yekim, with the host of heavens, I say, God, it is glorious to stand tall in victory. I'm standing tall. Let me say to someone, we are standing tall in victory in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Good morning, Britain.